the history of our pay gap analysis goes back to 2007, where we pulled the data together. It was a little bit of a shock for us at that time. In fact, our organisational's overall pay gap at that time was a staggering 43%. So it really was something that we all sat up and took notice of, and really something that we clearly understood action needed to happen. So for the next couple of years after 2007, we obviously put a number of initiatives in place. In 2010, we started to implement and set up diversity objectives. And some of those objectives were about reducing our organisational's overall pay gap, but also about increasing the proportion of women in the workforce, and also about increasing the number of women returning after parental leave. We monitor our pay gap regularly, and we have had it down as low as 7%. So I think that's been the real secret to our success. Certainly around increasing our proportion of women in the workforce. So when we were looking at our data, we had a 16% gender composition. We've been able to bring that up to 26% in 3 years, and only because we knew what the data was telling us. I'm quite surprised still in reading the WGA report that 73% of reporting companies still do not analyse their data. And I guess what I would leave them with is, if you don't know your data, then you don't know your problem, you don't know your issues, and you really can't action that.